ICSI, that is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Like in layman words, it is a term used for those patients in which when you're going for IVF technique, many times what happens that in IVF, what happens, an egg and a sperm is kept in a dish and the sperm automatically selects the egg. You're not guiding it. But in ICSI, what happens if you have got a low sperm count or the morphologically the sperm is not good? We like try it, we take the egg, we take the sperm and we make them fertilize. So that is called ICSI. Like you can say that it has been forcefully fertilized. So in layman terms, ICSI is a word used for forceful fertilization of an egg with a sperm. So it is done in all those patients who have got very low sperm counts, who have got recurrent implantation failure or recurrent fertilization failure, you can say, because there's no fertilization in them, the patient comes still. Thirdly, it is also done in patients in whom the egg quality, like the egg is very hard. The egg that comes out because of advanced maternal age. So we do laser assisted hatching also in these patients just to break the shell and so that the success rate increases. And plus, this is done in all the patients in whom all sperm retrieval techniques are used. So all patients who are undergoing TESA, TZ, micro TZ, they have to undergo the ICSI procedure. So that the ICSI procedure, there's no problem with you. Like there's nothing to be done on your body. It is whatever is to be done in the lab at the back end by the embryologist in which they forcefully fertilize an egg with your sperm. Thirdly, it is also done in several patients after the ICSI has come. There are many techniques that have come like piezo ICSI, IMSI, these have also come. Now the main barrier what comes in ICSI that the patient, they keep on reading things and many patients have got this query that does ICSI have more anomalous babies? Yes, if you say by literature, it does increases the risk, but the risk increased is only 2%. And that also is screened in the lab whenever the embryologist is doing it. So howsoever, they try to screen those things. And plus there are other procedures also available right now with which you can screen those embryos and then you can get them transferred in you. So the 2% anomaly that you are reading is really not a thing of like much concern. So ICSI is a procedure and is a boon for all those couples who can really get pregnant without not like they don't want IVF, they should go for ICSI. So please listen to your doctors whenever they counsel you for ICSI, because ICSI is not like a curse. It is going to help you deliver a child.